a white passe fagioli. In our stew pot, I have about, well, I don't know what's left. It started out about a third of a pound to a half a pound of nice, meaty, but still fatty, pancetta or guanciale. Now, of course, if you're a vegetarian, you can omit the pork from the dish. It'll still have great flavor. And some olive oil to coat the whole bottom of the pan. One large or two medium onion, celery. But then instead of carrots, I use fennel in the white pasta and beans. You make them sweat with salt. I'm going to throw in a couple of stems of rosemary, a couple of bay leaves. These beans are delicious Italian white beans that I bought a couple weeks back. And I soak the beans overnight and then give them a rinse. And I cook them, cover them with 3 inches of water, cook them in a gentle rolling boil until they're very tender in well-salted water with a couple of bay leaves and an onion to give them some flavor. This is the slow way. If you have the time, it doesn't take any effort. You just soak them and throw them in a pot. If you want to make this same night, obviously the shortcut is buy a couple of cans of cannellini beans. Or you could use borlotti beans or pinto beans. Pink or white beans is fine. And I'm just mashing them up a little to release some of their starch and break them down a little bit so it'll help thicken up the soup as the pasta cooks. So, in the pot, we've got the celery, the fennel, the pancetta all cooking together. Mm, and lots of onion. Then, once we get the sweat going on the veg, we add in our garlic. A giant chunk of the rind of Parmigiano Reggiano. I know. Makes the whole thing taste like a big pot of cheese. Now I'm gonna add a little lemon zest to the soup and lemon juice at the end. I love lemon, I especially love lemon in soups. So we're adding our bone broth in. And if it looks like you need a bit more, you can, you know, stretch it with water. But you want at least 3, 3 and a half quarts to cook your pasta in. We're gonna cook the pasta right in the pot so that all the starch, of course, thickens up with the beans in the soup. I'm gonna let the pasta go a couple minutes first so we can really get working. The pasta will cook in about 7 to 8 minutes. So I'm gonna crank up the heat, and when this comes up to a boil, add the pasta, roll the heat back just a hair. Now that the pasta has been boiling away for about 5 minutes, we're gonna stir in our half mashed beans from our strainer. And we're going to start wilting in the world's most beautiful escarole. So we're going to wilt in all of our greens at the very end. I like them to still have a bite left to them. The smart move would have been to pull out the Parmigiano Reggiano rind before I got to this point and added all of the beans and the greens to the pot. But there we go, I found it. Hello, buddy. Anytime I use dark greens, I always add a little bit of nutmeg. You don't have to, but if you got some in the pantry, just a little scratch. I mean, you're not trying to turn this into eggnog, okay? You're just trying to highlight the flavor of the greens. And then we add the juice from the lemon that we zested. So to this, we add a little bit of red pepper. We add a little bit of grated Parmigiano or pecorino, and we add a little bit of raw onion, and we add a fat drizzle of good olive oil. And there you go, pasta and beans.